we can say that the change is coming. AI, Gen AI, of course, is going to revolutionize and already changing the industry. I think that if we talked, I think a few months ago, it was like something that is going to happen, something that we foresee that will happen. Now we can say that it is happening. Okay, we start to feel it in our day-to-day work. I assume that you use Gen AI tools or AI-based tools. So am I. So it's part of our work. For me, you know, as someone that works for a company, for you as a consultant. So this is something that only going to, you know, be in a more rapid phase with time. So the change is going to change, like every industry is going to change this industry as well. I think that if I'm looking at it, the major change, at least at this point of time, will be in the way that data is reached. Okay, if let's say a few years ago, it was pretty hard to get right information, or you needed to go to a consultant in order to get, let's say, better or good information about one of the tasks that you have or one of the thing that you wanted to have information on. Today, it's super simple. It's a self-service for every procurement manager, procurement specialist, or everyone without a unique expertise in that. So I think that the need for consultant in this level is going down a bit and changing. With that being said, okay, by the way, it's also happening in the consultant side, right? Today, you want your consultant to be with all the information, okay, as a starting point. You want him to be someone that it will be knowledgeable, we know in advance the relevant topics that you're going to discuss about. And I think that the shift is more, or the need for consultant is more on the strategic level. The idea to get unique information or unique knowledge from the consultant. So this is the major, at least at the moment, with time. And you know, as the technology will grow, when the scenario will be more specific, or the scenarios that the AI, Gen AI will handle will be more specific. Again, the need for expertise, for specific expertise, will only increase. Yeah, so I believe that eventually, you know, when I think of it more and more, I think that there is no place for amateurs anymore in this field, okay? And with time, it will be more clear. Eventually, many people see themselves as consultants, right? Many people see themselves as experts. Mm-hmm. But in the situation where we are at now, and we're, you know, we are trying to foresee forward and see the rise of the machines as we're seeing it now, I believe that the ones that will gain from it, okay, then the consultant that will be continue to be relevant, these ones that will provide the unique knowledge, the one that have the creativity, okay, mm-hmm, will know how to bring the different approach, okay, to the market, to the client, okay, by using their expertise, their out-of-the-box thinking, or, you know, other things that relates to that. We know how to build process from start to end. We know to lead the client, okay, in his strategic process, or in the event that the consultant was hired for. And this consultant will not only continue to work in this changing environment, but will gain from it enormously. Also, I think that the ones that will be, you know, work with the technology, will know how to work with the technology in the way that technology will ease their work, okay, and will enable them to use with their creativity to provide this unique value to the customers. Again, those consultants will be the one that will gain from this shift and will be still be relevant and even more relevant in this changing world. So there are a few, let's say, aspects to that, okay? People, technology, and knowledge. And I will try to elaborate on that a bit. Mm-hmm. First, you need to have the right technology, okay? You need to embrace AI and data-driven tool as part of your daily work, okay? By the way, it's very easy to buy tools, okay? It's harder to convey people to adopt it, okay? By the way, if you're looking at the AI pillars, okay, you can see, you know, the need, okay? You need to have a need, you need to have a vision, of course. You need to understand what are the constraints in such a company, okay, privacy and things like that, okay? But eventually you need to have adoption. In order to reach your vision, you need to have adoption. Mm-hmm. And part of the more important things are to convey your team or to convey the company to use this tool and convey them that this will provide them value, okay, along the way. So this is one of the things. One of the things, again, to have the right technology. Second is to have the right people or to have the right learning path for people that are willing to embrace the technology. Of course, culture of innovation in companies, okay, that will enable you to continue with that. But I want to add another flavor to that, and that is, of course, create a good database. Eventually, I think that moving forward, if you're looking at the Gen AI and the development of such tool, a good tool is a tool that uses good data, okay, that has a good data. If you have good data, okay, you're able to eventually create good results with that, okay? And if you have a specific data, okay, because, you know, having general data and general information, that's one thing. But again, it's also a uniqueness for the consultants. If you have, an ability to reach to a unique data, and you combine it with the general data, and by that you can provide outcome, that's, you know, that's the holy grail, I think, here. So I think that, you know, when you frame to that, I think that this is exactly the phase we are in. For Gen AI, for example, okay, there was the initial buzz, okay, wow, Gen AI is going to change everything. And I think it's going, as I said before, it's going to change a lot of things and it's going to revolutionize a lot of industries. I think that now, after the first buzz, we're in the stage where tools are starting to emerge, right? And eventually, in just a few, let's say, months, okay, on the coming years, it needs to be proven, okay, that the buzz was as is. And I think companies, many companies, going to be eventually tested according to that. The market going to test companies according to their ability to provide AI tools that really make a difference, okay? Having an AI tool, okay, is not sufficient. Saying that you have an AI tool is not sufficient. Having a working AI tool that provides you value, this is the real thing, okay? And this is the real thing. And companies that will have AI tools in every profession, okay, that will make a difference, that will be easy to use, okay, that people will use because it is easy to use, it provides value, it's aligned with all what you need, eventually provided with the good results that you wish to have. These are companies that will march forward. Just a good advice to, I think, consultant, and a good advice to procurement professionals in every level. Embrace the technology, okay? See that you're on top of technology. Trying to make it as part of your daily work, even force yourself to do it, okay? Sometimes you will not see the value in the first day or in the first week, but if it will be part of your daily work, you will be in an advantage point. Again, as a consultant and as a user or procurement professional. Second is, okay, that prepare yourself to buy a personalized tool, okay, for you as a consultant, okay, that again will enable you to bring this unique value. And as a procurement manager or specialist or whatever, again, specific tools that will use the company specific data to provide you with what you need, with the specific value for your work. Mm-hmm. That's it.